Maglebee's Free Jacks beat the Legion in last year's championship game, but begin their title defense on Sunday in Charlotte, North Carolina, against a new opponent. Anthem RC, a fascinating joint project between MLR, USA Rugby, and World Rugby. Investment to develop talent in lower-ranked nations is not a new idea. Details and Structu has given the likes of Georgia and Portugal a way to develop pro players at home. To its great cost, U.S. Rugby knows how effective such work can be. Most of the Portuguese team that knocked the Eagles out of the last World Cup, then shown in France, played for Lusitanos in the Super Cup. The Anthem project was confirmed very late in the Miami Sharks, a second new challenger in the East. Anthem largely fielding American talent drafted from other teams. Maglebee says, taking away the fact it's a team coming in late, it's important that the Anthem concept, that USA Rugby, World Rugby, and a professional entrepreneurial league came together and made it work, is a s on the field who may not have gotten the immediate reps in Major League Rugby, and now they're going to have those reps. As long as we're patient with those athletes and give them those opportunities, there's no reason to think year after year of production of players that are American eligible isn't going to feed into a better MLR. On Sunday, Anthem's Young Americans will take on New England's mix of domestic talent and imports, a squad led by the fly half Jason Patras, last year's MLR Player of the Year from Taranaki in New Zealand. Young Free Jacks are among U.S. talent with Anthem. The 2031 World Cup looms over it all. Maglebee says, a World Cup in the prescient fayas. The 2031 World Cup looms over it all. Maglebee says, a World Cup in the United States will be very successful. You need just over 3 million fans, I think, to make it monetarily successful. There's no reason that more than 50% of those people won't come from overseas. The Soccer World Cup in 1994 is a good case study. Americans know.